Hey there, Tranny Star, this is Jules. I hope it's not too noisy out. It's kind of windy and there's a tractor in the background. But it's just such a nice day out, so I thought I'd make my video outside. So, this is my house. Well, that's not my house, that's my barn. We have 6 horses. I don't know if you can see any of them. Yeah, there you go, you can see them in the background. And this is my garden, or my mom's garden, rather. And over here is the house. Over there, that's the house. So, thought I'd share with you, because it's been pretty rainy all summer, so I haven't really had a chance to make any videos outside. But anyway, the topic for this week is religion. I basically just wanted to get to know everyone on Tranny Star and see what beliefs it is that make them people, you know, make all of us people. So, I think probably there are a lot of beliefs I was raised with. I was raised Baptist, but there was sort of a lot of fear of religion in my family growing up because my mother is schizophrenic, and right before she got ill, she got really super religious, and no one in my family had ever really been religious before that, but just before she got ill, she got saved and started going to church every weekend, and she started talking about it a lot for my family, and I don't know, maybe she saw that she was getting sick and needed that support system, but either way, a lot of people in my family are now afraid of religion because they think that it's what drove her crazy, which isn't the case. That's not true at all. But so I was raised with sort of this dynamic. Whenever I went over to my mom's house or my grandmother's, they were very religious and wanted to take me to church every weekend, but my dad's side of the family, my siblings, were all really afraid of religion. So, I was raised Baptist, and I really believed, but I guess I started questioning Christianity itself when, I don't know, when I turned like 14 or 15, I didn't really connect with a lot of the teachings. It didn't really make a lot of sense to me, and it just didn't feel like it worked. And for those of you who are Christians, there's really nothing against that. It just didn't work for me. For some reason, it didn't make sense. And so I continued to go to church because of the community, but then when I came out as gay, I got told by several people that I was going to go to hell and that I wasn't welcome, and so I lost that community connection. So for a couple of years, I just didn't really have a religion, didn't find anything. But when I first got to college, I met my girlfriend, and she's Jewish, and so I started learning a lot about Judaism, a lot about the different rituals and traditions, and it really hit home with me. I love the community. She follows Reformed Judaism, so I don't know, I love her temple that we go to, I love the community, I love everything about it. So I am converting to Judaism this semester, talking to our rabbi now about it. And yeah, but I think that more than any strict religious tradition, I guess I have sort of a bunch of non-religious beliefs that make up who I am, since my religious background has kind of, I don't know, not really been very strong. So I believe that there can be multiple truths for each person. I believe that there is no right answer when it comes to religion. There just isn't. Or culture, definitely not for culture. I think that everyone has something that works for them, and they need to find out what that is and follow it. And I believe that you know, a lot of people say, oh, this is the true faith, or this is the true faith. I actually really believe that whatever you have that works for you is true. And as long as you don't hurt other people, and as long as you don't hurt yourself, then what you're doing is good. So it's pretty basic, I guess. Let's see. I also believe that family and community is incredibly important. So, and that's actually one of the reasons why I love Judaism so much. It is a very community-based religion. It's not, well, you find your own personal relationship with God. It's, you can do that, but you also find your own personal relationship with the community. And there are flies. Okay, sorry. I was raised to believe, more than anything else, that family was the most important thing. And I still stick to that, and I've had a really hard time with my family. I got kicked out when I was 16, actually by my dad and my sister, who I moved after. So I kind of struggle with that, but I think it's really worth it to put in the effort. And I think that, for me at least, I don't know who I am without community. And I think that it's very difficult for anyone to know their place without a certain community that acknowledges them and loves them for who they are. And it's awful, really, really awful, when people get kicked out of their communities. I think that's probably one of the worst things that you can do to anyone. I think it's in Romeo and Juliet, when Shakespeare says that the greatest punishment for a person who knows their place is banishment. I'm probably saying that wrong. I can correct it down here when I'm done. But I really believe that. To know your place is a wonderful thing. To know where you fit in the world. It's such a big world. And it can get really confusing. So I like traditions that help remind us of who we are, you know. I say the Shema every morning and night. The Shema is a prayer which basically just acknowledges God and God's place in the universe. And I like that. I like being thankful for every day that I get. And I like being grateful for just everything out here. I mean, it's a beautiful day. I don't know. I think that's another thing that I was raised to believe. I was raised to never take anything for granted. Every day is a beautiful day. And I don't know. We shouldn't take people for granted. We shouldn't take our surroundings for granted. We should just try to make the best out of what we got, and try to respect everyone for who they are, and understand them all for who they are. And I didn't come from the most accepting family, but if there's one thing that I've learned over the years, it's that we really can't afford to judge anyone else. And I really try to hold true to that as much as I possibly can. We all have our different beliefs, and that's one of the most beautiful things about the world, is that there's so much diversity and so much out there to learn, and it's beautiful. So I guess those are the most important things to me. Knowing where I fit into the world, being grateful for what I've got, acknowledging that other people can have different truths, and it doesn't have to make sense to me. And yeah, so I guess that's it for this week. I hope you're all doing well, and I'll see you next week. Bye.